A somber night tonight in Lake Charles, Louisiana, where we are awaiting the worst that Laura has to bring. This likely will be ground zero, expecting a either direct landfall with the eye passing right over Lake Charles or just off to our west. Either way, we're going to be in that eye wall. We're going to have that historic storm surge that could be unsurvivable in places. Guys, it's terrifying. But look at this. Before Laura unleashes its fury here across southwest Louisiana, east Texas. Look at that. Say red sky at night, sailor's delight. Doesn't always work that way. Red sky, yes, not a delight at all. This is going to be just a night to remember for so many who have stayed behind, but even the families who have left that are watching this, of course, keeping up with the Weather Channel continuously. We're going to be all night long, all day tomorrow, and really all week covering this, not just at the coast, but all the way through. It's a long night ahead, and it's going to be an eventful one, that's for sure.
All right, Chris, thank you so much. I mean, things are going to go downhill pretty quickly here in Louisiana, unfortunately. We think that the northern eyewall here is just maybe 3 or so hours away from hitting us along the coastline and maybe 4 to 5 hours from hitting us in Lake Charles. 150-mile-per-hour winds, if you're just joining us, they've been going up steadily throughout the day. Could potentially even go up before landfall. Pressure 940 millibars continues to drop. What that means is the hurricane is still intensifying, and some of the more recent passes with the hurricane hunters have measured as low as 936. So it could still be intensifying right up through landfall. The official forecast from the Hurricane Center puts the winds at 150 at landfall tonight. I would say 150 to 155 is a pretty good bet for us this evening, but hurricane winds could go all the way to northern Louisiana and the Ark-La-Tex here. And then the storm filling the